Well, when I first started in ministry outside of the friendly confines of church ministry, I stepped into a world that I was very unfamiliar with. It happened to be motorsports. I didn't come from a background in motorsports, and I didn't know the language. I didn't know how tribal it was, the difference between motorcycle racers and boat racers and car racers or automobile racers. I didn't understand the language. I didn't understand the culture. And so when I stepped into that environment, I realized that I was an outsider. And in order for me to find a level of opportunity, I had to understand how that world worked. It wasn't a recreational competition. It was very high-level professional competition. So there were some parameters I had to learn. And it took me probably 2 to 3 years before I was really accepted into any of those communities that I served. And so part of what that required of me was to go and to be there and to observe and learn where the lines were, either visible or invisible lines, and to learn timing when it was appropriate for me to step into their world, to speak into their world. And so that was a marketplace, and I needed to gain a level of knowledge about how it worked before I could take steps into that space to speak, to engage, to have opportunity to maybe push a relationship forward. And so if we don't do that, if we don't take time to learn how that environment works, we may make errors that will impede the development of relationships. As far as I'm concerned, relationships are the conduit of ministry. And if we're going to be impactful in somebody's life who is an unbeliever, who is very committed to their community, their culture, their experience, their life, their world, whatever, however you want to describe it, we need to understand it. We need to respect it at some level in order for us to gain an opportunity to relate to that unbeliever who is so devoted to what they're involved with in that space, that community, that world in which they live. So I think it takes some time. And I think God's people need to move into those spaces and listen and learn and gain a level of knowledge that will allow them a level of understanding so that they know when it's appropriate for them to reach out and create relationships and speak.